on Wednesday, the president took two significant actions. One is invoking the Defense Production Act, which requires suppliers of infant formula manufacturers in the United States to prioritize deliveries of the raw materials that go into infant formula ahead of other of deliveries to non-infant formula manufacturers. So if a company supplied a good that is sought by infant formula manufacturers as well as another company, they have to prioritize the infant formula company first. That should ease some of the supply bottlenecks that have created the nationwide shortage of infant formula. The second action, and could that potentially have some more immediate impacts, builds off an action Monday by the Food and Drug Administration to ease import requirements for formula into the United States that's produced overseas. The FDA and U.S. regulators are going to determine which overseas manufacturers meet U.S. guidelines. And now President Biden has ordered U.S. agencies to work with the Department of Defense to use chartered aircraft to bring infant formula produced overseas into the U.S. expeditiously. That can potentially have fairly significant and rapid impacts on domestic supply of formula. Now, this is really an attempt by the Biden administration to show that it's pulling out all the stops to address the shortage. The seeds of this issue have been laid for months. Even before that, the plant in Michigan was shut down because of safety issues. There were challenges to supply chains for production of infant formula, like there have been challenges to the supply chains for everything virtually across the globe because of the pandemic. But that plant shutting down over the last couple of months has led to a fairly acute problem across the country in the supply of infant formula. And the White House, now that this is a massive national news story, feels like it has to take some fairly dramatic steps to show the country that it is working to address it.